Then last class we have learned about how to grow the plants, and coming to the fourth lesson, nutritious food. I all welcome you children because I am welcoming you. This is a very very important lesson that you have to follow whole of your life. Are you getting my point, my dears? You have to follow these nutritious food whole life. Why I am telling you? Because it is very very important lesson, and moreover, see, I said no already, a whole life, how we survive on the earth, whole life depends on three things, isn't it? What is that? Food, water and air. These are the essential things to survive on the earth. What takes first place? Food. What takes first place, children? I'm repeating you that the food is very important. Without food, can we live? No, we can't live. We can't survive. How can you say that? See, morning you'll get up, you brush. Don't eat anything, children, till afternoon. What you'll feel? 1 hour you'll be okay, 2 hours will be okay. Till afternoon, you'll be feeling hungry. Okay, if purposefully you don't eat anything, suppose on the day till evening, what you're feeling, you'll become so tired, isn't it? Till night, if you stay, you'll become more tired. If you go on, do that like that for 2 days, what will happen? You don't have any patience to move also. You can't do any work. You can't get up. You can't move. You'll feel very, very, very hungry. You feel tired. You can't move from one place. Suppose you see when you get a fever, isn't it? Fever time, you'll be not able to eat anything, isn't it? And after when you get the fever reduced, you'll become weak. Why? Because you're not taking any food properly. So that you'll become weak. So that is a very, very importance of the food, children. See, now take a pen and paper. Okay, take a pen and paper. Here, see, what is the lesson name? Nutritious food. What is the name of the lesson? Nutritious food. Today, we are going to learn in this chapter what is the importance of food. Okay, before going to the lesson, children, I'll ask you to take a pencil and a paper. Okay. I'll be asking the first question. I'll be asking the first question. Which food you like to have for your breakfast? Come on, right? You can write 4 or 5 items also. Your wish. What you like to eat in the breakfast? Okay, done? Okay, right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Your wish. Now, second question. Which food you like to have for lunch? Okay. Which food you like to have for lunch? What you all want to eat? Okay, right, no problem. Whatever you want to eat, that you like, children. Okay, the same. Which food you like to have for your snacks? That means evening time, no? Along with the milk or whatever you take, juice or whatever. What you want to have like your snacks, evening snacks? Did you write? Okay, I hope you all will write. Okay, and night. Which food you like to have for dinner? Isn't it? Which food you like to have for dinner? Okay, breakfast, lunch, evening snacks, and night dinner. Now, you wrote, no? Now, I'll go to the lesson, children. Before going to the lesson, what we learn in this lesson, let me teach you. Right, beside also you can write. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the varieties of food. What is the first point we are going to learn, children? Varieties of food. And what are the nutrients in the food? We are eating the food. Do you know what nutrients are there in that? We don't know. So in this lesson, we are going to learn what are the nutrients in this food. And thirdly, what are energy-giving food? What are energy-giving food? And importance of the food. What is the next point? Importance of the food. And next point is substances useful for growth. See a small children, isn't it? You'll grow day by day, you will grow. See in your class only, you see some are lean, some are short, some are height. Okay, different body structures you have, isn't it? Okay, So what, which substances are helping you to grow? That also we learn in this lesson. And lastly, know the importance of the healthy food. This is very, very important, children. Important point to remember. Know the importance of healthy food. And lastly, about junk food. You have to know about the junk food. It is very, very, very important. Now, let's start. We all need food, isn't it, children? We all need food. It provides us energy to do different activities, isn't it or not? It helps us to do the different activities. And it provides energy, okay? And to it helps us to grow. It helps us to do perform many activities. Okay, and what are the energy giving foods? From where we are getting energy? What are these actually? What? Why we have to learn for about the food? Isn't it not interesting, children? Now, you know, here, look all of you onto the screen, children. First, 4.1, in the nutritious food, we are going to learn varieties of food items. What are the varieties of food items? What we are going to learn? Okay, I said no, children, I asked you the questions. Keep that paper ready with you. I'm going to ask you a few questions after reading this 4.1, and also I'll explain. Then you compare what you have written and what is there in 4.1. Okay, children. Now, see, we get energy from the food we eat every day. So what is the first? Take a pencil and you can underline also, children. We get energy from the food we eat every day. Food helps us to grow and maintain good health. What it do, children? It helps us to grow and maintain good health. Let us see what Naveed, Aruna, and Sagar eat daily. So here are three children, children who are called Naveed, Aruna, and Sagar. Here, Naveed eats rice with pickle, chili powder, and oil. What Naveed eats, children? He eats rice. In rice, what he will use? Pickle, chili powder, and oil. He really drinks milk, eats fruits, vegetables, and leafy vegetables occasionally. Sometimes he buys junk food from the shop and eats it. So what here Naveed is eating? He is eating the rice with pickle, chili powder, okay? And he never drinks the milk. Sometimes he drinks, and very rarely he eats fruits, vegetables, that too, leafy vegetables, very, very occasionally only he will eat. Sometimes he go to the shop and he will purchase some food items like biscuits, chocolates, okay, whatever the chips like that he will buy and he will eat. This is the food habit of Naveed. Now, Aruna. Aruna likes to eat the food available in the market like chips, mixture, biscuits, ice creams, bread, jam, noodles, etc. Every day. She eats them daily. She does not prefer eating rice, vegetables, fruits, leafy vegetables, and pulses like dals. Isn't it, children? Why Aruna will not eat? Why Aruna will not eat? Because she doesn't like it. She wants to eat only which are available in the market. You see, in the market, if you go to the bakery, you can see number of items like chips, mixtures, biscuits, ice creams, bread, jam. Okay, in fast food centers, noodles. Okay, egg noodles, pasta, Maggi. These all are the junk food, children. She wants to eat every day that only. She don't like to eat rice at all. Okay. She doesn't prefer eating rice, vegetables, fruits, leafy vegetables, and pulses. She never eats that. Sagar. See, next para, Sagar. Sagar eats different varieties of food such as vegetables, cereals, eggs, leafy vegetables, fruits, etc. He eats homemade groundnut laddus and gingerly laddus. Besides these, he eats sprouts, that means germinating seeds, and raw vegetables, boiled or fried groundnuts, green grams, Bengal gram, jowar chapatis are taken as food in his house. Ragi malt is used as a food by them. Okay, children, what Sagar is, see, very important. Sagar is having very good food habits. Like what? Sagar eats different varieties of food such as vegetables, cereals, eggs, leafy vegetables, fruits, etc. He eats homemade groundnut laddus. Homemade groundnut laddu means, you know, palli laddu, isn't it? And gingerly laddus. Sise means nuvula laddulu. You know, in Telugu, palli laddulu, nuvula laddulu, he likes to eat. Besides this, he eats sprouts, germinated seeds, and raw vegetables. See, children, all vegetables cannot be eaten raw. Like carrot, you can eat. Beetroot, you can eat. Cucumber, you can eat. Those food items are being eaten. And sprouts, you know, sprouts. Yeah, you know, everyone nowadays, many of the houses are using germinated sprouts as a breakfast also. That also he will use. And he will eat boiled or fried groundnuts, green gram, Bengal gram, jawar chapatis, or are taken as in food in his house. So not only these children, they will eat boiled fried groundnuts, groundnuts in palilu, and green gram, pesarlu, you know, Bengal gram, shenagalu. Okay, they will boil and eat. And not only that, jawar chapatis, junna rotelu, you know, no, jawar chapatis, junna, that also they will take as a food. Ragi malt, you know, ragulu nowadays everyone is using. Ragi malt is also used as food by them. So how much healthy? Can you differ, children, what Sagar is eating, what Aruna is eating, and what Navid is eating? See, everyone is having different food habits. Even in our class, suppose there are 50 children or 45 children in our class, all are having different food habits. See, suppose in your class, example, Srinika is there, many girls, boys are there. All will eat the same breakfast? No. According to their food habits, they will eat, isn't it? They'll eat different types of which they prefer at home. Okay, but in this, all are good. Everyone is eating food only, no, you'll get a doubt. Teacher, then everyone is eating food. What is the difference? Why we are saying only some has good and some are not? Now coming to the Navid. So what we are telling, he is eating pickle and chili powder. It is not good for health, we are saying. Why? Why it is not good for health? Now coming to the Aruna. We are telling she is eating only the chips, mixture, burgers, noodles, that only which are available in the market. That only she is eating. We are telling that is not good for health. Why? Isn't it? Now coming to the Sagar, we are telling that Sagar is eating good food. He's having a very good food habits, like vegetables he's eating, cereals, eggs, okay, sprouted grams, okay, seeds he's eating, and boiled or fried groundnuts, and gingerly laddus and groundnut laddus he's eating, and he's having the jowar chapatis, okay, and he's drinking the ragi malt. Why we are saying that Sagar is having a good food habits? Why? Why? What is the difference between in this food? Yes, this is only the importance of the lesson. Now see, here are some questions. Why do you think Navid eats food only with the pickles? See, might be here is a question. Why Navid is eating only with the pickles? Might be we can't say anything, children, because might their parents are very poor. They can't afford the vegetables like the dals. They have to buy, no, they have to purchase. No, maybe they are poor, or else might be Navid likes only that pickles and chili powder and oil to eat. We don't know, but it is a bad habit. Okay, whatever it is a bad food process. Okay, now next, are Aruna food habits good? Why? Are Aruna food habits good, children? No. Why? Because, see, suppose if you take chips, they are deeply fried in the oil, mixture, that also deeply fried in the oil, biscuits, okay, they are also baked, lot of fat food will be there, ice creams that is stored in the fridge, refrigerator, bread, jam, bread is used with the maida, isn't it? And preservatives, noodles means preservatives, all these are preserved items. Preserved means they are made and put it for some months, isn't it? That is, which is not good for the health. So Aruna's food habit is not at all good. Now, of the three children mentioned above, whose food habits are similar to you? See, children, this is very important question. I asked you now to take a paper and pen and write the questions, what you'll have for the breakfast, what you'll have for the lunch, evening snacks and night, and take that paper and compare which what are the items you have written is suitable with Navid or Aruna or Sagar, and find out which food you are belong to. Okay, now among the three, whose food habits do you think are correct? Obviously, whose food items habits are good? Sagar's food habits are very, very good. You can see in the picture also, children, what all he is taking. And see here, this boy, Navid, what he is eating? Only the chili powder, oil, and a pickle. Isn't it? Are this good for the health? No. Now, why it is not good for the health? Why we have to eat the good food? How can we know that is a good food? These all we'll learn in the 4.2. Now, coming to the 4.2. Before that, I am going to read this para, children. Take a pencil and underline it. Our health depends upon the type of food we eat. Okay, every day we should eat all types of food items. We should eat the food which help us to grow, which help us to give energy and health, and which help us to develop immunity against the diseases. Do you know the components present in the food we eat? We don't know, isn't it, children? What the food help? It gives us health. Food gives us health. What type of health? How our health depends the food we eat. Suppose Navid is there. He is eating pickles, oil, and chili powder. When he falls sick, will be able to get immediately, cure immediately? No, he takes lot of time. He needs lot of medicines because he will have the immunity very less. Okay, our health depends upon the food we eat. See, children, in a school also, some will fall always sick because their food items, the food habits are not good. Because their food habits are not good. They want to eat whatever they want to eat, they will eat, and they will parents will give healthy food only, but they doesn't like to eat, and they want to always eat the tasty food. One thing I want to tell you, children, we should eat food as for health, not for the taste. What is the main point, children? The food, whatever we are eating, we should eat for our health, not for the taste. Actually, how dirty it is taste. It is not good. Why? Why we have to say all this? Isn't it? So we should eat the food which help us in the which helps improves our health and develop immunity. What is immunity, children? When you fall sick, like you'll get many fevers like typhoid, dengue, okay, smallpox, chickenpox are small. So these all will be affected. So when the disease affects, what you have to, you should have some support. The immunity power should be there. When you will get immunity power, when you eat all type of good food only, isn't it? So how we can know? Now, in which food there is energy? In which food we find the good things, teacher, you may ask. Now, coming to the 4.2, energy-giving foods. What are energy-giving foods? Energy-giving foods are cereals and millets. What are the energy-giving foods, children? Cereals and the millets. Paddy, wheat, jowar, maize, ragi, bajra, little millets, samalu, foxtail millets, korralu, are called millets. So paddy, you know paddy? Yes. You know wheat, godamalu, jowar, jonnalu, maize, makkalu, ragi, the small black color things, very small like avalu. Okay, bajra. These is very are called millets. And foxtail, korralu, samalu. These all are called millets. Millets means chirudanyalu. In Telugu, we'll call as chirudanyalu. These food items give the necessary energy to our body. So what if you eat this all, right? Paddy ante nothing but rice only, kada? isn't it? So we need energy to grow, to work, and also for our organs to function properly. Why we need energy to grow? And we need energy to grow and also to function our organs properly. Many organs are there in our body, like heart, kidneys, intestine, small intestine, lungs, brain. Many organs are there. So they have to work properly. They have to function properly. So these helps to function properly. The component which give energy are called carbohydrates or starch. So in this paddy, wheat, jowar, maize, what you find, children? You will find the carbohydrates or starch. See, carbohydrates are present in this, which is very helpful to grow, which will helpful to give energy. And millets contain more of starch. Nutrients like proteins, vitamins, mineral salts are also present in little quantity. So let us observe the following pictures of the millets and cereals which contain carbohydrates. See, children, along with the carbohydrates, see, first thing I want to tell you, take a pencil and paper and write what are the main things which the food contains. The substances which the food contains, what the body needs are, you know, like first thing is the carbohydrates. What are the first things? Carbohydrates, proteins, minerals, vitamins, and fats. Five things. What are those, children? Those are carbohydrates, proteins, minerals, vitamins, and fats. Now here, see the picture, ragi. These have lot of starch, good carbohydrate food. And maize, jonnalu, you can see, no? Makkalu. Paddy ante vadlu. If you remove that coat, no, rice ostundi. Okay, and you can see the millets, okay, small millets. Pachajonnalu antaru kada, that one. And you can see here, and wheat, godumalu. These all are very, very important. So children, which of the above do you not know? Okay, might godumalu means you'll prepare chapati and puri, no, children? Those are important. And what food items are prepared from the grains given in the picture? With this, we can prepare ragi malt. With this popcorn, you can make murukulu, those all, and idemo rice. And these are millets, okay? Chapatis. These also we can make chapatis and puris, okay? Which grains are eaten in your house? In your house, compare which grains you are eating. And why was the usage of ragi, jowar, and other millets decreased? Before that, in your days, many of them used to eat the food items like this. But now they are not using. Why? Why they have decreased? Why do we consume rice, wheat, or jowar mostly? Daily, children, you will consume most rice. Afternoon rice, night rice, or wheat, or jowar. Why we use this? Because these are the carbohydrate food. Okay, these are the carbohydrate food, which is very important for the body to give energy. Okay, and in this also there are proteins. In this also there are proteins, vitamins, mineral salts are present. Okay, now see next page. You can see the other food items also here. Potato. Potato is also there are carbohydrates. And sugarcane, isn't it? You can see sesame, groundnuts. Okay, this is sweet potato, sugar, honey, these oils. So potato, sugar, jaggery. Jaggery means bellum, you know, children. Sweet potato, some varieties of fruits also contain nutrients that gives us energy. So this also gives us energy. Butter. Okay, butter, ghee, and oils contain more amount of fats. These are also very, very important for us. Fats also gives us energy. Excess fats are stored in our body. The energy stored in the form of fats gives us extra energy when needed by the body. So why we eat fats? Fats, how they are important? Because the fats are so much important as when you don't eat food, the fat will be reduced. isn't it? And it gives the body as a substitute energy. Okay, so that's why the people are saying to eat the groundnut oil, ghee, butter, but too much consuming butter, ghee, this is very, very bad habit, children, because your body, the fat will be stored here and there and your body will become obese, isn't it? So we have to, these are energy giving food only, but we should use in limit way. Whatever it is, children, too much of whatever, if you eat too much of carbohydrates, it is not good. If you eat too much of proteins also, it is not good. If you eat too much of carbon, minerals also, it is not good for health. If you eat too much fats also, it is not good for health. It should be consumed in a proper manner. Then only it gives us energy. Now, one more thing, children. Here, food substance useful for growth. Now, these are the food substance which gives us energy. In 4.2, we have learned. And here, the food substance which useful for growth. See, some children will be very short. So, doctor, what they will prescribe? He will say, you have to eat milk, drink milk, eggs, okay, bodybuilding food like chicken, okay, meat. If you eat so much, no, you'll grow very fast. Not only those, like Bengal gram, green gram, black gram, chickpea, peas, etc. are called pulses. Along with them, milk, eggs and meat help in our physical growth. We grow well if we eat all this. If you want to grow properly with a good physical health, you have to eat this, children. These are the Bengal gram, shenagalu, isn't it? Green gram, pesarlu, black gram, minumulu, idli dosha, you'll prepare no those. And red gram, okay, kandipappu, okay, and you can see the chickpea, chikkullu, okay, bataneelu, milk, fish, eggs, and meat. These are very, very important to grow. These help us, our body, to grow perfectly. Understood, children? So, we have learned about the energy-giving food and also the yes. What items from the previous page do you know? What food items are prepared from them? Do you like them? Why? Which pulses are used in your house? What are prepared with them? Why can't everyone take eggs, milk, curd as food daily? Why? Children. So all the things which I have shown you, know, children, we will use. Isn't it? Pappu. Mummy, your mummy will prepare the pappu, no? So with different peser pappu, kandi pappu or chikkullu, you'll boil shenagalu, you'll boil or you'll make sprouts. Okay, green gram, Bengal gram, these all will be eaten by your parents and you too, isn't it? So every day you will use, or you will make with pesarlu and this pappulu, you'll make garelu also. Okay, pesar attu also you'll make. So different items are cooked and eaten by you people. But what is important? Why we are eating? If we eat this, what benefit you are going to get? That you have to learn. Okay, whatever the food item, suppose you are taking into your hand, afternoon lunch you are taking. You see what you are eating. Okay, rice you are eating. In rice, what is there? Carbohydrates. Yes, it is good for health. And you are taking egg. That means you are in that proteins are there. Suppose you are taking fish. Okay, it is giving the fat and also the proteins. Okay, like that you have to see and eat. Suppose you are eating chapati night. So what it is giving you? It is giving you the carbohydrates. Now, here, when some cells die, they are replaced by new cells in our body. For example, when we are injured, new cells are formed to heal the wound. Okay, nutrients called proteins are essential to heal the wounds. These proteins are found in pulses. Apart from proteins, pulses also contain starch, vitamins and mineral salts in minute quantities. In foods like fish, eggs, meat and milk, abundant proteins are available. Milk contains calcium, which helps in the growth and strengthening of bones. Hence, we should see that our food includes pulses, milk and eggs. See, children, when some cells die in our body, when you get fever or when you are feeling sick, what happens? Some cells will die and your body will become weak. And some new cells will replace your body. So, for example, when you are injured or get some, you have broken your leg and so much of blood has gone. So, new cells are formed to heal the wound. Okay, how the new cells will form? Nutrients called proteins are essential in healing the wounds. Nutrients called proteins. What nutrients are important? Proteins are important to heal the wound. Okay, if you want to get the wound very cure fast, what you have to eat? These proteins. Where you'll find proteins? You'll find proteins in the dals, pulses and a papulu. You see in your kitchen, there will be number of papulu. Okay, and that will be taken. And apart from proteins, pulses also contain starch. In the pulses, there will be proteins, also the starch and vitamins and mineral salts. In minute quantities, very, very, very small quantity, they'll be there. Okay, it is good. In foods like fish, egg and meat, meat and milk, abundant proteins are available. If you take fish children, if you take egg, and if you take milk, abundant nutrients you will get, abundant proteins you will get. So they are high protein food. What are high protein food? High protein food are fish, egg, meat. Okay. Now, milk contains calcium. So why I will ask the children to daily drink milk? Because milk contains calcium. Calcium means which help in the growth and strengthening of bones. You see, you know, you have bones, isn't it? In your body, there are number of bones. If you want to make your body strong, you have to drink the milk. Because in the milk, there is a abundant calcium, which is very, very helpful in making the bones very strong. Okay, hence we should see that our food includes pulses, milk and eggs. So daily children, you have to drink 1 glass of boiled milk and 1 boiled egg, and also compulsory in your food, whether it is a dinner or lunch, 1 dal should be there, 1 vegetable curry should be there, no pickles. Okay, no pickles, 1 boiled egg, 1 dal, 1 curry, 1 roti and little rice. That is very, very important, your diet. Then only it becomes a perfect diet. Okay, children, read the 4.1, 4.2 and 4.3. What are the energy giving food? What are the carbohydrates? What are the protein giving food? This all you have to learn and find out, isn't it? Underline the few hard words also. Okay, children. And see, last lesson, I did not give you the classwork, isn't it? Today, I have uploaded in the PDF. See the notes and complete your notes. Write neatly. Okay. Write neatly and complete your classwork. And find out the hard words also, children. Whatever the keywords are there, those and also the others. Okay. Okay, children. Bye. Take care.